back to our Christmas series. This series, we are learning about the true meaning of Christmas, and that is about Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Last week, we talked about trust and how we can always trust God's plan. Today, we will talk about what it means to know that Jesus is our Savior. Jesus was born so he could be our Savior. He came down to save the world. God sent his son Jesus to earth to save us from our sins. God loved us so much that he sent Jesus as our Savior. This means that Jesus came to save us from our sins. A sin is something that I think or do that God does not like. Because of our sins, we deserve punishment for the things we do wrong. But for good news of Christmas is that Jesus came to save us from that punishment. He came to save you and me. Jesus is our Savior. But first, let's stand up, warm up, and get ready to sing a song to Jesus. Hello, everybody. Welcome to our Christmas stretches. Now let's get our house all ready for Christmas. Now let's put up those candy canes. One arm to the left, and another one to the right. Okay, now let's do the Christmas tree, oh Christmas. Okay, now put a foot up.
Ooh.
Now hold on for as long as you like. If you need help, just be a boy.
That's a tricky one.
Yes. Okay, now let's do the cookie. Dip the cookie. It's a big cookie.
That's a big cookie.
Now eat it.
I love cookies.
That's it for today, everybody. See you next time. Bye.
Hello, everyone. It is so good to see you guys today. Why don't we stand up and let's worship together.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. Let heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and nature sing. Shout for joy, for the Son of God is the saving one. He's the saving one. Shout for joy, see what love has done. He has come for us, he's the saving one. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. Let heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and nature sing. Shout for joy, for the Son of God, he's saving one. He's the saving one. Shout for joy, see what love has done. He has come for us, he's the saving one.
That was amazing. Thank you everyone for singing with me. Have a wonderful week. See ya.
Thank you for singing along with us. Do you remember what our memory verse for the month is? It is, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David." Luke 2:10-11. Now let's watch this video lesson together to learn more about how Jesus is our Savior.
The story of Christmas. Jesus is born. This is Mary.
Hi!
You see, Mary was the mother of Jesus, but before that happened, she lived in the town of Nazareth. And she was engaged to marry a man named Joseph.
Heyo.
Hi, Joseph!
Got it.
Mary got pregnant by the power of God.
Wait, huh?
Joseph didn't understand all this at first, but an angel came and told him to still take Mary as his wife.
Yeah, okay.
So he did as the angel said. Not long after that, the ruler of the land, Caesar Augustus, wanted to count how many people were in the land. So Caesar Augustus ordered everyone in the land to travel back to their hometowns so that they could be counted. Joseph's hometown was Bethlehem, so Mary and Joseph traveled from Nazareth all the way to Bethlehem. When they arrived in Bethlehem, they looked for a place to stay.
No, I'm sorry. Oh, man.
But there was no room for them.
What about there?
Okay.
So they stayed in a barn, and while they were there, Mary gave birth to Jesus.
Whoa.
She wrapped him snugly in the strips of cloth.
That'll work.
And laid him in a manger.
Excuse me.
And so the Son of God, the Savior of the world, was born in a barn in Bethlehem.
What a great video to help us learn more about the birth of Jesus. Jesus was born to be our Savior. God sent his one and only Son, Jesus, because he loves us so much. Let's put our thinking caps on and listen to this next video called Get It, Got It, Good.
This is Get It, Got It, Good with Pastor Steve. Get it?
Got it!
Good.
Hi guys, I'm Pastor Steve.
And I'm Bezos.
And this is Get It?
Got It!
Good. Today we saw the story of how Jesus was born.
Oh yes, this is right. I remember that baby Jesus was welcomed into the world by a goat.
Well, there was probably a goat there, but do you remember why?
Because there were no rooms in the people's hotels, so they had to go to the animal hotels.
That's exactly right. Jesus was born in a barn in Bethlehem. God sent Jesus into the world to be our Savior.
Our what?
Our Savior.
What's a Savior?
Well, have you ever seen a superhero movie?
Oh, yes, lots of them.
Well, in those superhero movies, there's normally a superhero who's trying to save the people from some super bad villain guy.
Yes, that's like all of the movies.
Well, Jesus is our superhero, and he came into the world to save us from the super bad villain guy we call Satan. And you know, sometimes those movies, the superhero just is trying to help people who've made mistakes, or maybe they've made bad choices.
Oh yes, well, everybody makes mistakes sometimes.
Well, when we make bad choices, that's called sin. And Jesus came to save us from our mistakes and our sins. Jesus is the best superhero ever. He's already won against a super bad villain guy called Satan. And he's already saved us from all the bad things that we've done or even will do.
Wow, so Jesus was born to be our Savior?
Yes, he was. So if you make a mistake or if someone ever does something bad to you, remember that Jesus was born to be your Savior. So just call out to him and ask him to save you, because he will. Get it?
Got it.
Good. Love you guys. We'll see you next time.
I'm so thankful that Jesus came to save us from our mistakes and sins, and that Jesus has already saved us from what we've done and will do. Remember last week's lesson when an angel came to Mary and Joseph telling them that they were going to have a baby named Jesus? They were about to go on crazy adventure and just had to really trust God. During that time, there was a ruler of the land named Caesar Augustus who wanted everyone to report in on their city of their family's birth. Joseph was from the family of David, so he had to go to a place called Bethlehem. But while they were in Bethlehem, they were having trouble finding a place. So they ended up having Jesus in a barn. A barn is where animals live. How crazy is that? God the Father loves you and I so much that he sent his only son to come to earth in the form of a human being so that he can grow up and go through the same things we go through and feel the same things that we feel. That's how much God loves us. He did it for a very special reason. God knew that we needed to be saved from our sins, and no one else could do that except for Jesus. Jesus needed to come down to earth so that we could be forgiven and saved. Jesus grew up and died for our sins, and in the Bible it says that he rose again in 3 days. Jesus wants to know you. If you had never made Jesus the Lord of your life, and to know the love that God has for you, that really is the first step. We can ask Jesus to forgive us of our sins, and the scripture says that he will forgive you. Wow, I'm so thankful that God loves us that much. If you'd like to ask Jesus into your life, all you need to do is talk to him. You can do that right now or anywhere you are. Now let's watch this memory verse song to help us remember our verse of the month. Watching and learning with us today. We're nearing the end of our Christmas lesson. Go grab your notebooks to reflect on what God has been speaking to you today. What did you notice about the Bible story?
Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people.
Have you ever made a mistake or did something wrong and your grown-ups forgave you for it? How did it make you feel?
Joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord has.
Is there someone you could forgive today?
In Bethlehem, the city of David.
One thing you can ask God for forgiveness for.
Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. Don't be afraid.
We also have two announcements for you. First, we are starting our Advent Bible reading plan on December 1st. You can grab this at cachurch.info or in your email lessons. Second, during this Christmas season, CA Kids is partnering with our missions team by donating towels, children's shoes, and socks to our global partners in the Philippines called Gentle Hands. Gentle Hands is a child and youth welfare agency where they are in the front lines to help rescue and rehabilitation for the medical, social, and educational for at-risk children and youth. This year, the Philippines are facing one of the harshest lockdowns in the world, which has really impacted the kids and their staff. We want to bless them this year and support them where they are struggling. Will you partner with us by donating towels, children's shoes, socks, or by donating money towards the Gentle Hands? Drop off your donations at Kids Church in person, or you can donate online towards Gentle Hands. If you want more information on how we can give, connect with us, and we'll be happy to give you more information. Thank you for in advance for your generous giving and for your prayer for Gentle Hands. Our service is just about to start. Remember that Jesus loves you so much, and so do we. Bye! I bring you good news.